गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी हैव टू डिस्कस अबाउट सेकंड चैप्टर दैट इज पॉलिनोमियल्स एंड फैक्टराइजेशन। पॉलिनोमियल्स एंड फैक्टराइजेशन। सो बिफोर doing this chapter polynomials and factorization, first you have to know some basic definitions about these polynomials. What is polynomial, which types of polynomials you have, all those you have to discuss now. Already you learnt about algebraic expression in 8th class. What is algebraic expression, which types of algebraic expressions are there? So once again I am explaining those definitions to recall all those ones. What is algebraic expression? Algebraic expression. So algebraic expression means variable. Already variable means, you know what is variable? A symbol which can take different numerical values is called variable. Already you know that definition in your 6th class only. So variable means what? Symbol which can takes various numerical values. Similarly, constant means a symbol which has fixed value. So algebraic expression means variable alone, that means only variable, or constant alone, that means only constants, or variables and constants connected by four fundamental operations. Fundamental operations. What are fundamental operations? Fundamental operations are plus, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. These are the four fundamental operations. So algebraic expression means variable alone or constant alone, or variables and constants connected by four fundamental operations are called algebraic expressions. Algebraic expressions. So variable alone means you can take any variable, either x, y, a to z, any variables you can take. Next, constant alone means any numbers, 0, 76, minus 57, root 3, 5 by 3, 7 by 5, minus 146. Like this, we can take any numbers. So these numbers, this number having fixed value, that's why these are constants. You can take any variables, because you can take different values for these variables. That's why you call these as variables. For variables, you can take any variables like this. For constants, you can take these numbers. Next, variables and constants connected by four fundamental operations means you can take different algebraic, different expressions by using variable and constants. I am taking 2x. That means here, constant 2 and variable x connected by the symbol multiplication. 3y minus 1 by 3. This is also algebraic expression. Why? Because here constant, variable, these two connected by into, and minus 1 by 3 means constant. So these are connected by variables and constants. This is also algebraic expression. 1 by y. This is also algebraic expression. Because here 1 is constant and y is variable. These two connected by the symbol division. So So this is also algebraic expression. So 1 by 2x plus 3. This is also algebraic expression. Numerator is constant. Denominator, this is connected by variables and constants. So it is also algebraic expression. So in this way you can take different examples for algebraic expression. Now, already you know different types of algebraic expressions. What are different types of algebraic expressions? If algebraic expression is having two terms, we can call that algebraic expression as binomial. Three terms, we call that one as trinomial. So more than three terms, if we call that one as multinomial. So if an algebraic expression is having four terms, we call that one as quadrinomial. Here we have to know about polynomial. So polynomial means an algebraic expression in which the powers of the variables involved are non-negative integers is called polynomial. So polynomial means algebraic expression in which powers of the variables involved in that. So algebraic expression lo evaithe variables untayo a variable powers of the variables involved in that algebraic expression are non-negative integers means, so powers of the variables may be zero or positive, not negative. That means suppose if you are taking an algebraic expression 2x, this is an algebraic expression. In this algebraic expression, how many variables are involved? One variable is involved, that is x. So for this variable, what is the power? There is no power, means you have to consider that power as 1. Here 1 is non-negative integer. So we can call this one as polynomial. (7y-9). Here variable involved is y. For this power is 1. That's why this is also polynomial. Suppose if they give 1/x. 1/x you can write (x^-1). Here the variable involved is x. For this we can write 1/x as (x^-1). So here variable power is -1. -1 is negative integer. That's why it is not a polynomial. So if any algebraic expression, in that algebraic expression, what are the variables involved? Those variables are in denominators, then you can say simply that is not a polynomial. Ante ikkada algebraic expression lo polynomials enti ani cheppadaniki easy ga manam gurtu pettukovalante, okati denominators lo numerator by denominator ila oka algebraic expression unnappudu denominators lo variables unnai anukondi, not a polynomial. So only denominators lo variable unnapudu 100% it is not a polynomial. Next okavela so denominator ledu only numerators lo unnadi, then how you can check whether it is a polynomial or not? Suppose if they give like this root x, is it a polynomial or not? It is algebraic expression, because root x you can write x power 1 by 2. So this is an algebraic expression. But here the variable power is 1 by 2. So variable powers are only non-negative integers. 1 by 2 is not integer. That's why it is also not a polynomial. So if an algebraic expression having only numerator, by seeing the variable power, you can say whether it is polynomial or not. If the power is non-negative integer, you can say it is a polynomial or not. Suppose if an algebraic expression having both numerator and denominator, if the denominator having any variables, then simply you can say that is not a polynomial. So in this way you can check whether an algebraic expression is polynomial or not. So polynomial means what? Algebraic expression in which the powers of the variables involved are non-negative integers is called a polynomial. That means algebraic expression lo evaithe variables untayo aa variables ki powers non-negative integers e undali. Negative integers unnayante adi polynomial kaadu. Ledu power lo ila fractions unna sare adi polynomial kaadu. So algebraic expression in which powers of the variables involved are non-negative integers, then only it is a polynomial. So this is about polynomials. Types of polynomials. We have different types of polynomials. We have based on number of terms, based on degree of the polynomial. So we have different types of polynomials based on number of terms in the polynomial, based on degree of the polynomial. So I'll explain degree of the polynomial afterwards. Just by using these we have different types of polynomials. Here based on number of terms, type of polynomial. Here degree, type of polynomial. So, if in a polynomial, if number of terms is 1, so only one term is there, we can call that polynomial as monomial. If number of terms is 2, we can call that polynomial as binomial. Number of terms is 3, we call trinomial. Number of terms is 4. Quadrinomial. So in this way you can write, now based on number of terms you can write types of polynomials. So maximum up to here you can know based on number of terms which type of polynomial is. Similarly based on degree, if the degree of a polynomial is 0, we call that polynomial as constant polynomial. So if degree of the polynomial is 1, we call that polynomial as linear polynomial. If degree of the polynomial is 1, we call that one as linear polynomial. So if degree is 2, we call that polynomial as quadratic polynomial. If degree is 3, we call that polynomial as cubic polynomial. If degree is 4, we call that polynomial as biquadratic polynomial. So, polynomials are very important chapter. In the same thing, continuation and everything, 10th level also. So, here, based on degree, you have different types of polynomials. If degree is 0, we call that one as constant polynomial. Degree is 1, linear polynomial. Degree is 2, quadratic polynomial. Degree is 3, cubic polynomial. Degree is 4, biquadratic polynomial. Similarly, based on terms, polynomial having only one term. That means, here this polynomial having only one term. It is monomial. If they give like this, 2x plus 3. Here this is having two terms. So it is binomial. 3x minus 5y plus 4. It is having 1, 2, 3. Three terms. Trinomial. Quaternomial means plus 4 plus 7z. This is quaternomial. So in this way you can call these polynomials. Here based on degree. Suppose if your polynomial is like this, 2x plus 3. Here we can't consider number of terms. Only you can check based on degree. So what is degree of the polynomial? Degree of the polynomial means, in the polynomial, what are the variables involved in that polynomial? First you have to find degree of the monomial. After that, how many monomials are there in each polynomial? For all those monomials, you have to find degree. Among those degrees, which is the highest degree? That is called degree of the polynomial. So, once again, I will explain that one. Degree of the monomial, first you have to know. Next, degree of the polynomial, you have to know. So, monomial means polynomial. This is also polynomial. But polynomial having only one term is monomial. So, they give monomial degree. How to find degree of the monomial? Suppose, if they give 500. Is it a monomial or not? It is a monomial. Because, what we call this one? We call this one as constant. Here there is no variable. There is no variable means we can write that variable as into any variable power 0 you can write. Here you can consider here any variable power 0. That means which variable involved here? We are considering which variable? That variable you have to consider as variable. For that what is the power you have? 0. That means here what is the highest power of the variable in that monomial? What is the power of the variable involved in the monomial? We call that one as degree. Here, there is no variable means degree is 0. Because variable power 0, we can consider this as 500 into variable power 0, degree is 0. Suppose 3x is there. Here, what is the highest power? 1. So, degree is 1. If they give 3x square, what is the degree, highest power is, variable power is 2, so degree is 2. If they give 4x cube y square, here in that monomial, it is also a monomial. In this monomial, we are having two variables. So to find degree of this monomial, whenever you have one variable, simply you are taking that power as the degree. Here two variables are there in this monomial. That's why whenever you are having more than one variable, we have to add the powers of all those to consider that as degree. That means here, you are having two variables. These two variable powers, adding these two variable powers. 3 plus 2, 5. 5 is the degree. Suppose if they give like this, A, B, C, D. A, B, C, D means this is also monomial. Here, how many variables involved here? 4 variables. For all these 4 variables, what are the powers? So, by adding all these, that is the degree of the monomial, 4. So, in this way, you can write, or you can find degree of the monomial. Now, degree of the polynomial. Degree of the polynomial means, suppose, if you are considering 500. Here, polynomial, degree of the polynomial. Polynomial, degree of the polynomial. If you are considering polynomial as 500, same as example in monomial. So here there is no variable involved. So degree is 0. Suppose 2x is there. Simply you can write in this polynomial variable power is 1, so degree is 1. If they give like this, 2x plus 3y plus 8. Here this polynomial having 3 terms. But just we know up to how to find the degree of a monomial. That means only if an algebraic expression having polynomial having only one term, for that one term how to find degree, we learn in the previous definition, degree of the monomial. So only one term they give, here, here, here and here. In all these cases you have only one term. If you are having one term, how to find degree? Simply that variable powers you have to write. If the variables are more than one, all those powers you have to add, that is the degree. Suppose if they give polynomial, in polynomial, if you are having one term or more than one term, for all those also polynomials. Here, to find degree of this polynomial, here this is a monomial, this is also monomial, this is also another monomial. Because here, this polynomial having 3 terms. It is a polynomial having 3 terms is what? Trinomial. So it is a trinomial. So all these three. What are the degrees? For this, what is the degree? 1. For this, what is the degree? Variable power is 1. Here there is no variable means degree is 0. After finding degrees of each terms individually, among all these terms, which is the highest degree? 1, 1, 0. For this degree is 1. For this term degree is 1. For this term degree is 0. Among all these three, which is the highest? 1 is the highest. That is called degree of the polynomial. In that way you can find. Only variable ledu, direct rise. Oka variable undi, appudaina direct rise. Monomial ela find out chestamo, alane degree find out chestamo. Oka term e unde. More than one term unde. Suppose, inkoka example chudandi. 3x square plus 4x cube minus 7xyz plus 16x power 9. ఇలా ఇచ్చారు. ఇది కూడా పాలనమే లేదు. So here 4 terms are there. For first term, what is the degree? 2, because variable power is 2. For second term, what is the degree? 3, because variable power is 3. Third term we have 3 variables. For all these powers you have to add, degree is 3. For fourth term, variable power is 9, degree is 9. So among all these, here degree 2, degree 3, degree 3, degree 9. Among all these terms, which is the highest degree? 9 is the highest degree. Therefore, for this polynomial, degree of the polynomial is 9. So, in this way you can find degree of any polynomial. So, if the degree of the polynomial is 0, that means degree is like, that means constant. Degree of the polynomial, when you will get degree of the polynomial 0? Here if you are getting any constant, any number, root 3, 5 by 7, like this. If you are getting a polynomial, constant number you will get, you can call, for that degree is 0, we can call that polynomial as 0 polynomial. Sorry, constant polynomial. Next, if degree is 1, we can call that one as linear polynomial. Degree is 1 means that polynomial is in this form, ax plus b. ax plus b means you are having polynomial having only variable. What is the degree? For this, what is the degree? Variable power is 1, so degree is 1. Suppose if we have any number multiplied with this 5x or 5 by 3x or root 7x like this. For this, what is the degree? Here also variable power is 1, degree is 1. Suppose if they give like another constant, if I am adding 5x plus 7, 5 by 3x plus 9, root 7x minus 10. Again, for this also, what is the degree? Degree is 1 only. Because variable power is 1, degree also 1. That's why general form of linear polynomial is ax plus b. Next, degree, if a polynomial having degree 2, what we call that polynomial? Quadratic polynomial. So, general form of quadratic polynomial is ax square plus bx plus c. So, a quadratic polynomial lo, x term undochu, constant term undochu, x square term kuda undochu. But ippudu idi quadratic polynomial antaru. Here x square term not be 0. That means this x square coefficient not equal to 0. Here also x coefficient a not equal to 0. So general form of linear polynomial is ax plus b. Here a not equal to 0. Why a not equal to 0 means if a equal to 0, this becomes 0, b means constant, then it becomes which polynomial? Constant polynomial. That's why here a not equal to 0. If a equal to 0, it becomes constant polynomial. So it is linear polynomial. Similarly here, why I am writing a not equal to 0 means, if a equal to 0, this becomes which polynomial? Linear polynomial. That's why here a not equal to 0. Similarly, cubic polynomial also. Ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus, this is general form of cubic polynomial. Here a not equal to 0. If a equal to 0, this cubic term becomes 0. We call this one as which polynomial? Quadratic polynomial. So here a not equal to 0. If a equal to 0, it is not cubic polynomial. So this is our cubic polynomial. General form of linear polynomial is ax plus b. General form of quadratic polynomial is ax square plus bx plus c. General form of cubic polynomial is ax cube plus bx square plus bx plus c. So this is about types of polynomials. So polynomials based on degree is what? Constant polynomial. Next, linear polynomial. Quadratic polynomial. Cubic polynomial. So constant polynomial means you can take any number. General form of linear polynomial is ax plus b. Here a not equal to 0. Similarly, general form of quadratic polynomial is ax square plus bx plus c. Here a not equal to 0. Similarly, general form of cubic polynomial is ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d. Here a not equal to 0. So this is about types of polynomials based on their degrees. Similarly, based on the terms, number of terms, what are the types you have? First one is monomial. Second one is binomial. Third one is trinomial. Fourth one is quaternomial. Based on number of terms. If number of terms is 1, monomial. Number of terms is 2, binomial. Number of terms is 3, trinomial. So, in this way, you can call based on number of terms, you can call the polynomials like this. Based on degree, we can call the polynomials like this. This is about types of polynomials.